Hi, my name is Rima Ilebo, MD, and I'm the Medical Director of the Natural Solutions Foundation. Today I'd like to talk to you about one of the greatest threats to our health, our freedom, and our ability to determine what happens to ourselves that I personally can ever remember. It's called, deceptively, the Food Safety Bill. S-510. Congress is on vacation right now, but as soon as it returns in September, if the plans of the globalists and the people who want to control our food system totally go through, this bill will be rushed through as a non-contested bill. And it will be passed by unanimous congressional consent, as if no one had any conflicting opinion about the bill. What does the bill do? Well, through regulation and through the imposition of enormously difficult and expensive requirements, paper requirements, physical requirements, and so on, it simply eliminates all local farming. It eliminates organic farmers. It eliminates garden farmers who grow their own tomatoes and so on. This bill is the triumph of agribiz. It is the industrialization tool for the entire U.S. food supply. It brings all of Codex standards and guidelines into implementation, despite the fact that we've been holding them off bit by bit, piece by piece, for years. This bill means that no farmer can save seed unless they're a multinational giant which can afford to build $1.5 million seed sorting facility for each type of seed they wish to save. This bill will mean that organic farmers have to do what the central regulatory system tells them to, which is to use dangerous, harsh chemicals, the very opposite of organic farming. It means that small farmers will be faced with such enormous burdens that they will not be able to keep farming. In essence, it criminalizes clean, unadulterated food and the growing of that food. What to do? Well, since last November, when this horrible bill was unanimously agreed upon by the members of the Senate and set to pass through the voting process, and we rose up and we said, "Don't you dare," with 150,000 emails to our members of the Senate over a single weekend, Congress stepped back, the Senate said, "Oh, maybe we better not do that." And since then, we've managed, through our continued pressure, to keep that bill from being passed. That bill must be pressed against and pressed against and pressed against until the end of this congressional session, at which point the bill will die. How to do that? Go to www.healthfreedomusa.org. Click on the link that tells your congressman that you want a hold placed on that bill. The hold means that it cannot be voted on as if there were no differing opinions, without any vote, any discussion, without any opportunity for other people to express their views. The hold is produced by your senator contacting the Senate cloakroom and saying, "Put a hold on S-510. And that hold stays on there as long as your congressman says it does. If you and your neighbors, your friends, your family, and the people that you can reach contact their senators by riding the freedom mouse, as we like to say, taking a few minutes to take this action And we do this in large numbers, and then we tell the people that we can reach. This is important. This is one of those bills that can change the world in a negative way if we don't defeat it. If we spread the word and we mobilize everyone we can reach, this bill will never see the light of law. If it does pass, you and I, our children, our loved ones, will suffer and we will die because of the universal contamination of our food. So please, go to www.healthfreedomusa.org and take the action in which you ask your member of the Senate to place a hold on S-510. Use that freedom mouse as if your life depended on it, because it does. Thank you. This is Rima Ilebo, MD, reminding you that health freedom is our first freedom.